You're a lot.
You're a lot. Hey, guys.
Happy Friday.
Happy Friday.
Friday. I said it first.
You win.
Okay.
Okay. All right. So we are excited. Both of us are on here today. And one thing that we've noticed in the process, we know I love teaching you new finishes. I've, you know, kind of taken you on my journey as far as our last trip to New Orleans. And there's a lot of people that are just getting into the aspect of DIY, redoing furniture, decorating their homes. And we thought, you know, it would be really be beneficial if we kind of did a breakdown of each one and explain the differences and also why we created each one.
Because we've expanded.
Yes.
Our line.
Yes.
Of coatings.
Yes.
We started with the one step and now we've got
four categories.
Well, five if you count milk paint.
One, two, three, four. That's a primer. So, Gene promised he would behave himself today. So, he's our technical guy. And a lot of you may not realize this. Some of you do, some of you don't. But we actually manufactured furniture for almost 30 years. And so, we manufactured very high-end furniture. And our premise and our, I guess what you could say, what we were most known for in our furniture were our finishes. Mm-hmm. So that's why we developed each one of these products to be able to give you the opportunity to be able to create a lot of different looks. So as you pop on here, say, hey, hey, Beth Ward. As you say, hey, we can see your names. And that way with T and with us here, hopefully we've got four eyes on the camera. We can see your questions and we can answer them because we want you to understand how to use these products and to be successful.
Can you write bigger? I'm having trouble seeing some of that.
All right. So let's start with the milk paint. Nope. And then we're going to turn this down and we're going to go over it because we want you to be able to see all the different ones. So the milk paint comes in how many colors?
It comes in, hold on. 36.
36 colors. We have 36 gorgeous colors of our milk paint. The milk paint is the product that you want. If you want a very distressed finish, you want to be able to antique it. You want to be able to go in and create multiple colors. Milk paint is it. Now, milk paint is not good outdoors.
No.
Milk paint cannot be used on fabric. Milk paint cannot be used on what else?
Slick surfaces.
Like appliances and things, glass. Milk paint is not it.
Metal.
Milk paint is what you want to be able to use when you want to be able to get a very antiqued finish. So
furniture or your cabinetry.
Right. So let's turn this down. I want to move these away. I want you to be able to show people and I want you to be able to ask questions on here as far as what you may have. Hey, Martha. Hey, Christine. Hey, guys. Hey, and here's the deal. Every time we do these lives, if you share this video and tag some good friends that you know love creating, and we say crafting a beautiful life, your name goes in for a drawing, and we're going to put some products together that we're showing you today, and we're going to be giving that away. So all you have to do is share this video, tag some good friends, and that way we'll announce the drawing on Monday afternoon. All right, so let's go in and do the camera down just a minute. So the milk paint is going to come in a bag.
Mm-hmm.
It's dry.
And it lasts forever in the powder form. As long as you don't mix it, the shelf life is
forever. It's indefinite. So once you mix the milk paint, if you want to go on and do that and show everybody how this is done. Once you mix the milk paint, it's going to be good for about 2 weeks. So with the ratio of mixing the milk paint is going to be one part water and one part powder.
That the caveat is it's got to be in a sealed container in the refrigerator.
Yes. So if I'm doing a project with the milk paint and I'm going to be painting it tomorrow, a lot of times I'll make my milk paint the night before. That way I don't have any granules. I don't have any issues. And there are instructions on the back of the milk paint. And I have a lot of YouTube videos as far as how to use the milk paint. that you can go and look at. So what you're mixing up, if someone is going to be painting a piece of furniture, there are 17 square feet in one bag. So let's say you're going to be painting a chest of drawers and you want to be able to do it in a really beautiful milk paint finish, you're going to want approximately 3 bags of milk paint. So the other thing is, if you want to get a cracked finish on your milk paint, you can use the cracked gesso underneath. But the main thing is we want to kind of go through each one of these paints so you see. Now, we've mixed up. The color that we've done here is called Southern Gentleman. That is what is on this trim piece. Now, look, what's one of the first things you notice, what you just mixed up in this?
Well, in its liquid form, it's much darker.
Right.
And also, unlike latex paints and oil-based paints, your milk paint is very thin. It is not the consistency of latex. It's not as thick. It's a much thinner viscosity.
And that really is difficult for a lot of people. They'll think, well, I'm supposed to make the milk paint as thick as I would an acrylic or the one step, which is very thick. Mm-hmm. But if you do that, you're going to get really heavy coverage and you won't be able to do beautiful antiquing like this. So let's just show us, what brush do we need to use?
On this, we're going to use the chip brush.
So it's really best to use a natural bristle brush when you're working with milk paint. The coverage is also really good with the milk paint. The other thing that you're going to see, this color that you see that is so dark is going to dry down to be much, much lighter. And again, we have 36 milk paint colors. They're all fabulous. That I just, y'all know that I have a weakness for milk paint because I love the diversity that I can get from it when I want to be able to antique it. So it's going to dry down, then I'll go through the antiquing process. But we have lots of YouTube videos that you can watch on that. All right, so the next one that we want to be able to go to, and before we do there, the brush that you're going to use, you're going to use a chip brush, which is a natural bristle. The coverage is in one bag is 17 square feet. You can clean it with soap and water. And as far as outdoor use, you do not use milk paint on outdoor use.
Now, the caveat again with that could be if you use the milk paint binder.
True.
With the milk paint, which right. is an additive
right.
we have. Would give you the ability to use it outside.
Right. All right. So, all right, as you pop on here, just keep saying, tell us, hey, and then ask us questions. We want to go over each one of these because they're all so totally different. So the milk paint is when you want to be able to have this really antique finish. The milk allows you to lift. When you use the antiquing glaze, you can lift the dried milk paint. So it allows you to be able to get these really distressed finishes. Now, the one step is the next one we're going to go over. Here is one piece of the sample that's been painted with the one step. Now, the one step, the only way to be able to antique it is how?
Sandpaper.
If you want to be able to get a distressed look, the way to do it is to be able to go with your milk paint because it's natural, it's really pretty, it's very, it looks like it's worn very authentically. The one step paint is just that. It is about one step. You don't have to sand, you don't have to prime, and you don't have to seal it. Now, if you've had any experience with other chalk-based paints, do you want to hold that up for them and let them see? If you've worked with chalk-based paints, part of the beauty in it is the fact that it allows you to be able to create a lot of different looks. Ours is not an acrylic-based paint. It is a calcium carbonate-based paint. So a lot of companies have created flattening agents in acrylic-based paints, and they call it a chalk-based paint. You're never going to get the same look. Part of the beauty in this is this dead flat matte finish. But here's the other great thing. There are other chalk-based paints that if you get water on your chalk paint, before it is sealed, it'll come off. Ours is not that way. The one step will allow you the versatility. If you do not want to seal it, you don't have to. It is a flat matte finish. So part of the reason why we do the one step with the milk paint is because this is a great first color to use.
Foundation.
It's a foundation. You can use it with cracked patina. The other great thing, if you want to be able to create really beautiful waxed finishes, like the cerusing wax, which is a gorgeous white wax on top of this, it's beautiful because you've got this very absorbent matte finish. The other thing, if you want to be able to paint on top of existing cabinets, so let's say someone has oak cabinets in their kitchen.
Yes.
What do they need to do before they paint it with the one step?
Clean them.
That's it.
You just use the clean slate to get all the wax, oil, grease off of those cabinets, and you're ready to go. There may be, if you've got a, you know, a crack, a chip, a hole, you know, fill that with a wood filler before you paint. But then you can go with the one-step paint. And you don't, as Amy said, you don't have to sand it, prime it, or seal it before, or strip it before you use the one-step paint.
You know, a lot of questions, too, that people ask, can I use milk paint on my kitchen cabinets? The answer is yes. We did it on our shareboard house. And they were fantastic. People think you can't clean milk paint. Now, here would be my suggestion. Seal it really well with a light antique wax. And then that way, the longer the wax is on there, the harder the surface gets, and you can buff it. So we had four kids, and we would have a lot of teenagers over, and we never had any problems with our milk paint cabinets. But if you want to redo your kitchen cabinets and you want to use the cerusing wax, or you want to be able to use the embellishing wax, if you want to be able to use the light antique wax or mind your own beeswax, you can use the one step. If you don't want to seal the one step, you don't have to either. Here's the other thing that I wanted to make sure that you knew. If you want to paint upholstery, you know, we do this a lot. We paint upholstery, your fabric, your club chairs, leather, your outdoor furniture that we've got in the summer that a lot of them are mildew. The one step is the only paint you can use to paint upholstery. You do not use milk paint. You do not use any of the other ones. So the one step is what you want to use when you're going to paint upholstery.
And you can also use this in a sprayer. So if
it's very easy to use in a sprayer.
If you got a paint sprayer, you can use the one step through the paint sprayer.
All right, so let's turn this down. Let's show everybody as far as we're going over the difference of the four categories of paint. We went over the milk paint. Now let's go over the one step. All right. So let me give you a piece of wood.
Okay.
Is it going to be important to stir the one step?
Yes. And, you know, before you use any of the paints, you want to stir it.
This is one of our favorite colors. It's one of our best-selling colors, which, by the way, the one step comes in 101 colors. And this color is a beautiful dark gray. Here, babe. It's a beautiful dark gray, and it's called A Good Man is Hard to Find. And so I named it after Gene because he has gray hair, but this is a dark gray. All right, so it comes in 101 colors, and we have a one-step paint chart that is actually hand-painted dots. It's the actual paint colors that you can get. You can just order it on the website.
And when you do this, don't try and paint your project in one coat. It's not, even though it's called one step, it's not one coat. What you want to do is you want to take it and brush it out. And you want to, it's better to do thinner coats than a thick coat.
So the other thing, this is the same color. I want you to see after he painted it on and then what it looks like after it's dried. So it's going to dry down to this beautiful matte color. The other thing is you can use this outdoors. You can paint upholstery with the one step. You can paint concrete with the one step. You can paint your shutters. You can paint your surfaces that already have lacquer on it, it's strictly cleaning it with clean slate and then painting. There's no sanding, priming, or prepping.
Lawn furniture.
And lawn furniture. You can paint lawn furniture. I painted my grill with this. I know Jean said don't do it, but I actually painted my grill and it looked doggone good.
Yeah, keep in mind, there is a point that it's too hot for the one-step paint.
You can paint marble. You can paint brick. A lot of people do their brick facades. Mm-hmm. You can paint. If you want to be able to have a matte finish, mm-hmm. the one-step is perfect for that.
If you've got brick around your fireplace, you can do that.
You can do that. All right. So I just want everybody to see this is much thicker
than the milk paint.
And and it comes in 101 colors, and it's water-based. So you can clean it with water and use a natural bristle. All right, so now let's go to the next one.
Okay.
We're going to go over the Miracle Paint. Let's talk about the difference. If you'd hold that up so everybody can see that. This is a question a lot of times. What's the difference between Miracle Paint and One Step, and why would I use one over the other?
It's a miracle. Is this a hypothetical question, or do you really want an answer?
So a lot of people wanted to be able to have a finish that did not have a matte finish to it. They wanted it to be sealed. Mm-hmm. That's what the Miracle Paint is. The Miracle Paint is sealed. It has more of a kind of a satin finish to it. You don't use it with any wax. I would not use cracked patina with this.
No.
If you want to be able to do your kitchen cabinets, your bathroom vanities, your countertop, any of those projects, and you want to be one and done, this is it.
Yeah, and another thing is this has more leveling agent in it than the one-step paint, so you'll have less brush marks with the Miracle Paint than you do the one-step paint.
The Miracle Paint also covers 130 square feet. It's also available in every color that the one-step paint is. So we have 101 colors.
Like the Dalmatians.
That's right, of the Miracle Paint. So let's show everybody how to brush it on. So guys, as you pop on here, please be sure, ask me questions, and we're going to be going back and answering all of them. But we wanted to make sure that you knew exactly how to choose which product to be able to have for your project. All right, So the Miracle Paint is it's a little bit thicker than the One Step.
Mm-hmm.
It is self-leveling, and you can spray it. It's going to cover, again, 130 square feet. This is one of my favorite colors, and it's an Italian silver. I use it as a base even for a lot of my milk paint projects. So are you using a chip brush, or are you using a synthetic brush?
This is actually a synthetic because, again, a synthetic brush will really help eliminate those brush marks. We want to put it on thinner than thicker, so that, one, it dries quicker and it does help with the brush marks.
So with the Miracle Paint, you can use this outdoors. You can use it on iron. You can use it on concrete. You would not use it on fabric, but it has a lot of versatility to it. It is very, very hardy. You can spill things on it and clean it off. It has a beautiful satin finish. You would not use this if you wanted to be able to finish it off with a wax. You wouldn't use the Miracle Paint if you wanted to be able to do antiquing. This is about a one and done. You don't have to prime it. You don't have to prep it. It's all self-sealing, and it does have a leveling agent in it. That is a gorgeous color and a gorgeous finish.
Mm-hmm.
I love that. All right. So last but definitely not least, let's go over the LuxeLacquer. So there are those of you, we have all these different looks that we want to be able to get in our homes. We want to be able to have different rooms, different textures, different feelings. And that's part of the beauty, especially when you are creating different projects, whether you want to be able to have a milk paint look, you want to be able to have something that's a more solid coverage and durability. then you want to be able to have high gloss. You know, I have heard that on Cherish, the resale site, one of the fastest growing finishes that and most highest selling is a lacquer finish. So we wanted to be able to create a lacquer finish that had a 96% and above gloss. When you paint the LuxeLacquer, you can see your reflection.
It's beautiful.
It's beautiful. The other thing is, would you just hold up that LuxeLacquer that we've got? And then I'll hold this and then grab the toaster. Now, here's what's interesting. Can you see the sheen on this? It's crazy. Look at this. The high gloss of this is insane. And we have 52 amazing colors of the LuxeLacquer. Just like the One Step, that we have a color card that you can buy. The One Step color card you can also use with the Miracle Paint. So that way the same colors are available and it'll allow you to see exactly what it will look like. Now, look at this. You can use this LuxeLacquer on appliances. You can use them on toasters, refrigerators, your kitchen cabinets. You can use it on walls. It is the product to be able to use when you want a really high gloss finish. So we also have color cards in the LuxeLacquer, look at this, that allow you to be able to see the colors. The other thing is we don't have the One Step colors available because they're more muted. They're a little bit softer. When you want to be able to have a really high gloss on lacquer, as a rule, you want to be able to have very highly pigmented, bright, vibrant colors. And so the LuxeLacquer is perfect. If you want to be able to do walls, I'll tell you, we're actually getting ready to paint the LuxeLacquer in our grandson's room when he visits us. We'll be painting the trim and the ceiling, and then I'm wallpapering the walls. So, but if you want to be able to do your kitchen cabinets, why are you smiling?
Yeah, I know who's doing the painting.
I dream it up. You paint it. And, you know, a couple of weeks ago, we showed you how we're painting our doors in our house. Black lacquer. Jean was really excited about that, too. The LuxeLacquer is perfect for that, especially here. One of the things, it's summertime, we're outside, we're doing outdoor projects. You can paint your front door with a LuxeLacquer because it has a UV protectant in it. I'm just going to tell you, depending on the color of your house, do you see Helene's comment? Let's go, Jean. You can do this. I love that. But a front door in LuxeLacquer can really change the whole curb appeal of your house. It can make it look amazing. Can you use a stencil and a rub-on transfer on the LuxeLacquer? You can definitely use a stencil.
Yes.
Because it would be great if you want to even be able to gild on top of it. A transfer, I believe a transfer would actually stick.
I think it would work.
Yes. But look at that. Is that not divine? And I love this navy. So fab. All right. So do you want to, would you paint a piece of trim for me? Now, do we have one primed? I guess we don't. All right.
There you go.
Oh, you need to stir. All right. I'm going to turn this down because I want you to be able to see as far as the LuxeLacquer. Again, it's really thick.
You know, the nice thing too about the LuxeLacquer, because it's oil-based and it's the only product, the LuxeLacquer primer and the LuxeLacquer paint, they're the only products that we have as far as coating, paint coatings that are an oil base. And because of that, your brush marks are virtually eliminated. Yeah, it's so minuscule. And the same thing, you can roll this on or you can spray this on. If you roll it, use a microfiber roller and like a quarter inch nap if possible, 3/8 at the thickest. And when you roll this or brush this on, you want to use a synthetic brush. You want to put this on thin, because if you put it on heavy,
thin.
If you put it on heavy, especially on a vertical surface, it is going to sag. And it can also start causing some cracking if you get it too thick.
So the type of brush that you use is going to be a synthetic, and I like the trim brush. It's a much thinner bristle. Let's go over real quick. What kind of prep do we need to do before we paint the LuxeLacquer?
Well, on the LuxeLacquer now, on ours, on this one, and
because we really should be doing the primer.
Because it's unfinished, it's raw wood, we would put the primer on first. And the reason being is the primer seals. The primer's great to give you a smoother surface because you're going to lightly sand between coats. And keep in mind, when you sand, you want to wear a respirator or dust mask when you sand. Use it in a well-ventilated area, too.
A lot of you that are, you love flipping furniture. You love buying it, and it's kind of a side hustle, which that's how we got started. And the LuxeLacquer is very, very desirable with a lot of interior designers. The nice thing about it is for the product and what it has and what it does, it's priced very, very reasonable. The only similar type product that is like our LuxeLacquer is made in another country, and it runs almost $300 a gallon. So this is very affordable. It allows you a lot of versatility. And again, we have the primer that if you're working on raw wood, you want to be able to use it first. But we wanted to show you as far as how to be able to brush it on. Again, it is about putting it on very, very thin. Don't worry about this first coat having all the coverage. We are more concerned about it being very thin. You're going to need to clean the LuxeLacquer with mineral spirits. So the projects that this is best with, you can use this outdoors. You can use this indoors. You can use this on walls. You can use it on cabinets. You can use this on metal. You could literally use, you could paint your mailbox and your lawnmower and anything else with this paint.
Just
not small children. That's right. So the LuxeLacquer gives you a lot of versatility for outdoor use. We're outdoors right now. We have, as an example, let's talk about what we have outside. We have metal lawn furniture. Mm-hmm. You can definitely paint the lawn furniture with the LuxeLacquer. Mm-hmm. The cushions, you can paint with what?
One step.
The cushions can be painted with the one step. This is the only product that's going to paint the cushions. What else? We can...
you can do masonry.
You can do cement. You can do brick, anything that you have like that. You can paint floors with the LuxeLacquer, and it can be done on top of oak, and it can also be done on an existing surface that has a sealer. So, like, if you have an existing, let's say, brake front, or they have a dresser, and it already has a factory finish on it, they don't need to prime it.
No.
That's important. The primer is really only needed when you have a very absorbent finish surface or raw wood.
Especially like if you got a mahogany, a walnut that's grainy, a lot of times, and they've been stained and clear coat, a lot of times that they didn't fill that grain, so you can still see the graininess, the pits from the grain in the finish. So you could use the primer for that. To seal that with, and then lightly sand. And also on these directions, a little different. A lot of times you can recoat in a couple hours. This is a overnight. You cannot, you've got to wait 24 hours to do recoating. Again, this has to dry long enough before that second coat. Again, you'll get the sagging, or it'll get too thick and it'll start to pucker and crack.
I think, one, I love this color, and I just love lacquered furniture. I think it has a place in almost any interior, even if it's just white lacquered with gorgeous gilded knobs on it. It's absolutely fabulous, but I love the fact that we've got so much diversity. Mm-hmm. Now, there was a question on here. If you paint fabric this Nora and Dave with the one step, does the fabric have to be a natural fiber? No. You can paint vinyl. You can paint leather. You can paint leather with the one step. We had customers. It was so fun because with the one step, and we're going back and forth, with the one step, We had a gal that had an old white sofa that was cracking, and she said we were either going to throw it away, or we said we're going to paint it and see if it works. They painted it a dark chocolate brown, and then they waxed it, and it looked like suede. And they kept it, and they used it because it's so great. The one step combined with the wax, it is really a repellent. You can pour red wine on it. You can pour it in Coke, and it wipes right off. So if you want to be able to paint an old, ugly, what's one of those fabrics that they had on sofas that was not a natural fiber?
Well, you have to be careful because it can't go on a thick fabric.
Like a mohair
or a thick velvet or Herculon, because what happens is it really makes that fabric hard and stiff. So you wanted to use it on a very thin fabric, thin cotton, thin polyester, even silk.
But out of all of the paints that we have, the one step is the only one that you can use on upholstery. Mm-hmm. So Lynn has a question. Can you use transfers on milk paint? Yes.
You can use transfers on. Keep in mind that your milk paint is more porous. So it'll have a tendency to draw that that transfer in.
You know what I would do? If I was going to use a transfer on the milk paint, I would use our matte sealer. The matte sealer it's fantastic. If you've never worked with it, you can brush it on. I like using a sponge brush. And you'll see no brush marks, and you will see absolutely no sheen. It is dead flat matte. So it seals that milk paint. And then that way you can put it, you can put your transfer directly on top of that.
I went to school with him.
What?
I went to school with him.
With who?
Matt Sealer.
Anyway, all right. When I ask him to do this with me, I just don't know what he's going to do. And I think it's funny. All right. Will this work on a metal storm door? Yes. It's fabulous. Yes. On a metal door.
Yes.
You can use the LuxeLacquer on metal, on wood, and you don't have to prime it if it already has an existing finish on it. And just show them again. Show them my toaster again. I want them to be able to see the finish. So if you have cute mixers, if you have appliances that are just really ugly and you're like, I would love a bright pink refrigerator in my art room, or I would love a mixer in a really fun coral color, then the LuxeLacquer is definitely the way to go. So I hope this has answered some of your questions. We're going to go back through and, okay, hold on. Somebody is painting a tub with the one step. They can do that.
You can't. You've got to be very careful because even though these are very hardy, except for the milk paint, these are very hardy. They're very durable, but they can still, if it's heavy enough, it can scratch, it can chip. Mm-hmm. So you want to be very careful. And if you're using it for your tub, you want to give it a 3 to 4 day cure time. Mm-hmm. Let that paint cure before you start using it.
And on my tub, if I was painting the one-step paint on my tub, I would also probably use a Mind Your Own Beeswax on top of it, just to give it a really pretty finish.
On the outside.
On the outside,
yeah.
Yes. On the outside. Absolutely. You can also use the LuxeLacquer on a tub. Mm-hmm. Wouldn't that be fun?
Mm-hmm.
Here's another thing. If you have really ugly tile in your kitchen that you're like, I can't afford to have it all torn out, you can use the LuxeLacquer on tile and paint directly over it. You'll paint over the grout and you'll paint over the tile. So you can use the LuxeLacquer, the One Step, and the Miracle Paint on clay pots, on big containers, mm-hmm. on metal. It has a lot of versatility. Do you have to always wax the One Step on fabric? Share with them why we put the wax on the fabric.
The wax does two things. One, it helps to, even though your one-step paint seals, it helps to seal it even more so, especially if you drop food, drop drink on there, it comes off. But it also helps to soften that a little bit as well, so it's not as stiff.
Because the nice thing is, and I've got some great videos on YouTube where I go in working with the one-step paint on fabrics, is that I will do a combo of a little bit of water, fabric softener, and one step. And when you paint that one step on cottons or in low nap fabrics, whether it's your outdoor cushions, whether it's your sofa that's leather or vinyl, that it's very easy to work on and you don't have to prime it. When you paint that on, sometimes it acts like it, like whiskers. I think a lot of times it raises that. Mm-hmm. So you might need to put the wax on and knock that down by sanding it mm-hmm. before you wax it just a little bit. Mm-hmm. So we're going to, there's so many of these questions just kind of coming up. We will go, let me see, plastic to peel off an RV in plastic shower walls. What do you think about that? We've had so many people use the one step in redoing RVs and trailers.
Mm-hmm. Well, they're talking about those inserts that they use for a shower wall.
I would use a LuxeLacquer.
Could do the LuxeLacquer, yes.
The LuxeLacquer would be hardy enough. Mm-hmm. It'd be fabulous for that. Mm-hmm.
Again, you're going to have to give it on the LuxeLacquer because it's oil-based. Probably a 5 to 6 day cure time on that before you use it.
Right. And the other thing is a lot of people, when you are comparing price, when you look at acrylic based paints and you look at the price of it, and then you look at the price of our paint, there is no comparison. The quality, the pigmentation, a lot of times when you've got really inexpensive paints, there's not a whole lot of pigment in it. It's kind of made at the barrel of the vat, the bottom of the vat, mm-hmm. Or the bottom of the barrel. The nice thing about it is we use only very expensive ingredients when we're making our milk paint, our one-step paint, our miracle paint, as well as our LuxeLacquer, because we want to be able to have a really great looking finish. And we want to be able to make sure that you have success and our promises stand true. So hopefully this has been informative. It kind of debunks when you wonder, when you go to the site and it's like, which paint do you want? And that way you see the versatility of it and also the array of colors. Again, we've got 101 colors in the One Step and the Miracle Paint, 52 colors in our LuxeLacquer, and 36 colors in our Milk Paint. Let me see. Barbara has a question. I bought a fabulous industrial chair with chippy paint, which I'm going to sand off. Do I have to use the primer if I want to use a LuxeLacquer?
Well, if that's an industrial chair, is it metal or is it wood? Either way, I would use the primer. Be sure and wear some type of respirator when you sand. You don't know what kind of paint that is. If there's any lead in that, you want to make sure you're protected.
Yes, and two, you can... the LuxeLacquer 32 ounce, you can get anywhere between 100 and 130 square feet mm-hmm. as far as coverage. Mm-hmm. The main thing is just to go thinner and yes. do more coats and go yes. thin. Yes. Do you want to show them real quick as far as the sandpaper? Now, the one step, the Miracle Paint, and you don't have to worry about the sandpaper as much. The LuxeLacquer, you do want to use sandpaper.
Yes, I mean... when we sand between coats, we use 220 grit sandpaper. This is a wet and dry sandpaper, but you don't have to use that. You can just use the regular dry sandpaper, which is usually a tan color or a kind of a brick red color. We just happen to have whatever the hardware store has and the grit we need, that's what we get. But we'll use 220 to sand in between coats.
All right. So now you've got a holiday weekend coming up. You've got an opportunity to be able to be outside. So start looking around and think what you want to update, whether it's your planters, your umbrella stand. You can paint your umbrella fabric with one step. Give it a fresh new look. It's going to amaze you at how great it's going to look. There's going to be all these projects you can do outside. And we're going to be able to make our homes even that much more beautiful. Think of all the husbands.
Got a lot of work this weekend.
And friends, they're going to be called to be able to do their projects. We hope you have a fabulous July 4th week and weekend. And we can't wait to see the projects that you do. Mwah. Thanks, guys.
Thanks for joining.
Share this video. Tag some good friends. Your name will go in for a drawing. We'll be giving it away and we'll announce the winner on Monday. Thank you.